pretty.
Yeah, I love Mach 1.
I love this color.
Isn't it called like fighter jet gray or something?
Yep.
Yeah.
Great looking car.
We're good.
Michael and Chuck.
Mike.
Good to see you, buddy.
Yep.
All
right, let's go ahead and grid on out. All right, so real simple, man. I want you to, the first lap out, I would like you to call out every flag station and say they're manned or not manned.
Okay.
Then just drive, brother.
Okay.
Make it real easy on him. Love this car, by the way.
She's not liking the seat.
So on this, other than calling out the flag stations, I just want you to drive like you normally would. You know, 8 or 9 tenths of what your maximum is. Just, you know, do what you do.
Okay.
You know, your instructor is one of the best ones I've ever seen. He's fantastic, and he says you're going to do really well. So that's what I expect.
Good, going good, excellent. Yep. Good, turn the AC up a little bit though. Yeah, you got the AC, man. Yeah, let's not help with my engine. Oh, that's good. That's because you're in a Mustang. Yeah. <laughs> Gotta get a bigger radiator in the winter. Yeah, Chuck's keeping his mouth shut for me, but we're with Camaro guys, you know. There's a couple of you guys here, you're going too fast. We're surrounded by greatness, but you know. <laughs> Oh.
So Dave was my initial instructor when I first started this. He was my first ever instructor.
And look at him now.
Right. I could mess up like a whole lot of things now.
About 3 minutes.
Gotta love this. This is really pretty. And they did not mess up the engine in the Mach 1 either, which is great.
Yeah. I put the shaker on it because I should have been there from the start, but outside of that, it's pretty much all the same.
Cool.
I got new rotors, nice pads.
What brakes are you running?
Off DTCs.
Which ones, 60s or 30s?
60 in the front, 30 in the back.
Perfect.
Perfect. And then it's got the Steeda two-piece rotors.
Okay.
And then in the winter, when I got money again, I'll do the rear seat delete and put it in a cage. So then I can do a Hans and all.
Bolt-in cages work great. You know, that's what I've got in mind. You know, custom-built cages are nice, but they're very expensive.
Yeah.
I think mine's made by RSR Studios. So it's like $1,600.
Yeah.
Put it on myself. Easy day. Now, the most important things you've already talked about, brakes.
Yeah.
You know, that's the most important thing in our cars because our cars are not the lightest. The 60-30 setup is one of the best ones. 60-60 in this car is a problem because it overbrakes the back of the car, and it'll induce a little bit of slide. But it's, yeah, they're the cheapest, best brakes there are, period. You just can't beat them price, you know, and you track, let's see, who is it? One of the track places, one of the tire places, I think, puts them on sale every so often. I'm not sure which one. Tire Rack. Yeah, Tire Rack will put them on sale every so often, like 50% off.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah, it's crazy.
I gotta check that.
I ran 70s and 60s on my car for a while, then I switched to a Giro pad because I'm running different rotors as well. But the Hawks did great.
I did not like their rotors though. I had the Towns or whatever, and they only lasted like 4 or 5 track days.
Heavy car going fast.
Yeah.
I run geodisc rotors at the front of my car, and I can usually get about 14, 15 track days out of them, but I've got to change just the rotor rings.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I got now, the 2-piece, so.
Yep. Saves you some money.
They're still more expensive then, but at least I won't have to spend what I spent this year again.
Yep.
Like that, just what should be safer and what should be faster, so it's win-win.
All right, so first lap out, call out the flag stations.
Yep.
Thank you. bike. Excellent. went pit in this time. Let's go ahead and go to the trailer real quick, the chin trailer. Give them a point by, give them a point to your right, let them know we're going in. Straight to the track. Just pull right in front of my Camaro. There. Excellent work. Excellent work. You did very fine. We got no problem with you going solo. A couple things to, for you to work on as you continue to go, and it got better towards the end. So down here at this straight before you come into 10, mm-hmm. be really careful about braking where that little lump is.
Okay.
So as you're coming down, you go underneath the bridge, it's hard to see, but there's a little transition down. And you felt a couple times in our first two or three laps, actually you were braking and the car is getting a little bit unsettled. Either do your braking before or do it after. You at the end of the last two or three sessions, the last two or three laps, you did fantastic of entering in 10 great. Your car control is exceptional. The back end of this car does dance around a little bit. You catch it every single time. Turn three was the last two times you did turn three up there. The left-hand sweeper, as good as anybody I've ever seen. You're absolutely fantastic there. Ideally, what you want to work on is getting to the point where you only brake once. It's hard to do here because you're like over brake, going to one, then come out, then have to brake again. So learn as you continue to, just turn it off.
Well, no, just that low pressure.
Does that do that all the time?
No.
Kill the engine. So work as you continue to move up, right? As you continue to get towards blue and then red, everything else, work on one brake application and then rolling off at it. Okay, when you're having to brake twice, that means what you normally are doing is you're braking too early or you're braking too hard. Car control is fantastic. The traffic management is fantastic. You're definitely one of the fastest ones out there. So everything is good. So my only suggestion to you is to work on the braking at various places and then continue with the car control. The car control is great. Three, we were loose all the time. We were loose here a few times. There was one, I think the second lap, you came in way hot.
Yeah.
And you're like, but you immediately saw what you did and immediately adjusted and went from there, which is something we as instructors like to see because I don't have to tell you anything. You did it by yourself. I mean, I didn't give you a single instruction today to do anything other than flag stations. You got all those, you did very well. So let's go in here, let's get everything filled out for you, get your new wristband.
Okay.
But good work, man. Really good work, Mike.
Thank you.